student, I Srinamgarkar from DA Public School welcomes you in today's video session. So our today's topic is the next chapter, that is moving charges and magnetism. In class 10th also we have discussed about the magnetic field, magnetism, induced magnetism, electromagnetic induction and so on. On the basis of that topics only we will do further discussion in class plus 2. So our main topic is moving charges and magnetism. What do you mean by magnetic field? In the last chapters, we have discussed about the electric field. Electric field was related to the electric charges. But here we are doing magnetic field that is also linked with the charges. But how? We can see this thing. Suppose I am having a current carrying wire through which current is passing. What I have? I have taken a current carrying wire through which current is passing. And when current is flowing through that wire, the compass, any magnetic compass that we will take will start getting deflected. The needle which will be there in the magnetic compass will start deflecting. Now what it explains? It tells us that when we bring any current carrying conductor or current carrying wire near to the magnetic compass, the magnetic needle starts getting deflected. Means when current starts flowing through the conductor, magnetic field is created over there. Understood this thing? Again I am repeating, we are having a current carrying wire. When current will pass through this wire, the compass which is brought near to the conducting wire, its needle will start getting deflected. Why deflection will be there? Because magnetic field will get generated due to this current flowing through the conductor. Now the next equation is about the direction. In class 10th, we have discussed right hand thumb rule, in which we have done this thing that if the current is flowing in the upward direction, like here, current is flowing in the upward direction, then magnetic field lines will be inward, in our direction. Again, I am repeating, if the current is flowing in the upward direction, the magnetic field lines will be inward. And here, if the current will flow in the downward direction, suppose current is flowing in the downward direction, magnetic field lines will be outward. So, that is the concept behind the direction of magnetic field lines. I hope these things are understood by you, that how magnetic field and electric field are related with each other. One more important thing, when you are doing electric field, it was not a big concern that either charges were moving or not. If charges were moving, then also we produced electric field. When charges were at rest, then also electric field was produced. But here, the difference is here, main difference between electric field and magnetic field is that when the charges are at rest, there will be no magnetic field. Magnetic field is noted by capital letter B, as we have noted the electric field capital by capital B. So, I was telling that when the charges will be at rest, there will be no magnetic field. Please keep this thing in your mind. It is very, very important that a magnetic field is valid for the moving charges only, not for the charges which are at rest. Suppose I have this current conducting wire in which current is flowing, and any charge I just brought near to the conducting wire, and this charge is at rest, there will be no production of any magnetic field. Yahan pe magnetic field produce bhi nahi hogi. Now the question can come in your mind, hame kaise pata chalega that either magnetic field is getting produced or not. We can bring magnetic compass over here, and if the needle of the magnetic compass will get reflected, we can observe that your magnetic field is getting produced. But if the needle will not get reflected, magnetic field will not be there. Here we see, here our charge is in motion. I brought a charge over here, and that charge is in motion. My charge is moving. And if charge is moving, then I can say magnetic field is produced. Clear this? So, the magnetic field is noted by the capital letter B, and it is valid for the moving charges only. Our next concept is that how can we determine the magnetic field produced in a current carrying conductor. For that we are having a specific topic that is known as Biot-Savart's law. That law is used for the determination of the magnetic field. Which law? Biot-Savart's law. In that topic, what we will do? Please try to understand it clearly. It is very, very important and mainly used for the determination of the magnetic field line near to the current carrying conductor. Again, I will take current carrying wire. Suppose that I have current carrying wire and I have to find the magnetic field near to this. I want to find magnetic field here now. मेरा जो करंट है वायर में से फ्लो कर रहा है एंड ड्यू टू दिस करंट इज फ्लोइंग चार्जेस आर मूविंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन विल गेट प्रोड्यूस एंड आई वांट टू फाइंड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ओवर हियर सो व्हाट आई विल डू आई विल जस्ट जॉइन दिस द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस वायर एंड द पॉइंट वेयर आई हैव टू फाइंड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट डिस्टेंस आई विल टेक एज स्मॉल r नाउ करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन द अपर डायरेक्शन अ लॉन्ग वायर आई हैव टेकन टू more easier what I do I take just a small element of this wire small element I can take it as dl again dl ki wajah se itni element length ke element ki wajah se yahan pe magnetic field produce hoegi it is obvious because earlier we have discussed that if the current is flowing in the conductor certainly magnetic field will get produced now you want to identify you want to determine the strength or I can say intensity of the magnetic field. Here the distance between that element or I can say length element and here P is the observation point where I have to find the strength or intensity of the magnetic field. There will be the angle theta. Can I draw it? That is the angle theta between the distance and the length of the element or length of the wire which I have taken smaller portion. Clear? Now, as I told you that magnetic field is denoted by capital letter B. Magnetic field is denoted by capital letter B. Now, अब जितना ज़्यादा current pass होगा, it is obvious magnetic field की strength भी उतनी होगी. As the current is passing, as much current is passing, more and more will be the magnetic field. So, magnetic field is directly proportional to current passing through the wire or any conductor. So I can write B is directly proportional to I, current passing through the wire. Second thing, अब जितनी बड़ी length लेंगे wire की उतना ही ज़्यादा current pass होगा and that much strongly magnetic field will get produced. जितनी ज़्यादा wire की length होगी उतनी ही strongly magnetic field will get produced. So magnetic field is directly proportional to length of the wire also. As we are taking a small length, so I can write here dB, dB, and that dB is directly proportional to dl also. Clear this? The further important thing is dB is directly proportional to sine theta. Now, if theta will be 90 degree, that is angle is 90 degree between the wire and the point where we have to find the magnetic field, then magnetic field will be maximum. Just remember this thing, agar hamara ye theta 90 degree ka hai, to hamari magnetic field kya hogi? Maximum. As we are decreasing the theta, theta yahan pe aa gaya, yahan pe agar 0 degree ho gaya, no angle is there, then minimum or I can say zero magnetic field is there. Clear this thing? अगर हमारा थीटा जितना ज़्यादा एंगल होगा किस चीज़ में बिटवीन द लेंथ ऑफ वायर और वायर एंड द पॉइंट वेयर वी हैव टू फाइंड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड उतनी ही ज़्यादा हमारी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की स्ट्रेंथ ज़्यादा होगी इट्स इंटेंसिटी विल बी मोर सो दैट यहाँ पे फाइंड करना पड़े मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो ऑब्वियसली डिस्टेंस इज वेरी लार्ज. अब जितना ज़्यादा डिस्टेंस होगा मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की स्ट्रेंथ उतनी कम होती जाएगी. जितने ज़्यादा क्लोज होगा तो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की स्ट्रेंथ उतनी होगी ज़्यादा. सो इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू टर्म्स. नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू, आई विल इक्वेट ऑल दीज इक्वेशन एंड आई विल गेट dB इज इक्वल दैट टू प्रोपोर्शनल टू IdL sin theta upon R. मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, करंट, लेंथ, एंगल बिटवीन दिस टू टर्म्स एंड द स्क्वायर ऑफ द डिस्टेंस. व्हेन आई विल रिमूव दिस प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कांस्टेंट आई विल गेट म्यू नॉट अपॉन 4 पाई आई डी एल साइन थीटा अपॉन आर स्क्वायर. दैट इज अ प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कांस्टेंट इन द केस ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. As in the case of electric field, we have done this thing. Force was equal to Q naught E and that was equal to Q, Q naught 4 pi epsilon naught R square. This case in my case, kya tha? 4 pi epsilon naught. In the case of magnetic field, we have mu naught upon 4 pi. That was the permittivity of free space and that is the permeability. Permeability means that is कितनी magnetic field lines को permit करेगी so that it can pass through the wire. That is a permeability. Mu naught upon 4 pi. Further discussion will be in the next video session related to this. For a while just see this thing. Mu naught upon 4 pi IdL sin theta upon R square. Now we are left with the units of the mu naught. What will be the units for the mu naught? The units for the magnetic field is Tesla. Remember this? The units for the magnetic field is Tesla. Hamari electric field ki kya unit thi? F upon mu naught electric field. Force ke newton, mu naught ke coulomb. The units for the electric field was newton per coulomb and the units for the magnetic field is Tesla. Now I want to find the units for the mu naught. What will we do? dB के यूनिट्स क्या लगेंगे? टेस्ला. 4 पाई इज कांस्टेंट. आर स्क्वायर उधर चला जाएगा. टेस्ला मीटर स्क्वायर. करंट के यूनिट्स एम्पीयर. लेंथ के यूनिट्स मीटर. दिस इज कांस्टेंट. सो दीज आर द यूनिट्स फॉर द मू. दिस इज आवर रिक्वायर्ड एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द बारक सेवर्ट्स लॉ व्हिच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर न्यूमेरिकल पर्पस आल्सो. दिस विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल. Next topic, many other topics will be related to this chapter that we will do in the next video sessions. Thank you. Have a nice day.